Careful. Careful. This will lead. May 30th. This morning we entered uncharted territory, leaving the sun-bleached bones of Dead Horse Camp behind. It seems the tables have turned on Rally, almost quite literally. His bandaged leg has slowed his pace and made him the tail of our party. When Father notices, he slows, turning around to give us both an encouraging smile. His overly eager step betrays his calm demeanor as he rushes past us at the sight of every nearing turn, ridge, or embankment. Go be the one to chart the path from this life to the next, so that we may all travel safely. This seems to describe a hidden chamber nearby. To be the way up. This polished piece of silver is lined with gold and inlaid with turquoise gems. It appears to be a decorative mirror of sorts. An ornate filigree depicting Ishel is carved onto its backside. My dear Nina, once again the attempt to write is fraught with difficulty. However, those flies and bees and bugs galore that I wrote her before, all of those pinhead-sized stinging horrors, would have been a welcome attrition now that I have faced down tooth and claw. I fought bravely, but the confrontation did not go in my favor. I will spare you the details out of compassion and not egotism. My wounds have been packed with yarrow and are stable, but I can feel infection in the blood. If you are reading this, then you know I have not survived this place. I instructed Jack not to go on. We lost young Rimmel a few weeks ago. This place, Nina, is not meant for the likes of men, and I will not rob you of a son as I have a husband. I'm tired now. Jack is sleeping by the fire, and I am certain that when he awakes, I will have slipped into my own slumber. I love you, Nina. Good night, Percy. August 9th. I am leaving this page here to assuage any mystery should the rest of this quest prove as fatal for me as it has been for my party. My name is Jack Fawcett. I set out from Cuyaba Mato Grosso on the 20th of April, 1925, with my father, Percival Harrison Fawcett, and my best and longtime friend, Rally Rimmel, in search of Zed. I am the only one left. My father was lost to a pair of fierce jungle cats and Rally to Blunder. I myself am worse for wear but refuse to give up. My father believed we are close to Zed and so do I. So leaving two graves behind me, I will push west still with the hope that I am not walking to my own end. In the early 19th century, this was used to measure the angle between an astronomical object and the horizon for the purposes of celestial navigation. There's an inscription here. To my son, Jack, may you never lose sight of your horizons. Every part of the world seems to have its own mythical, forest-dwelling, bipedal creature. Around here, it's known as the Sisamite, the guardian of the forest. Described as large and ape-like, it's rumored to kill male humans on sight, but takes the females to its cave for mating purposes. depiction of a Pook, god of death and ruler of Mitnel, the ninth and most horrible level of the Maya version of hell. One thing a Pook enjoyed doing was dressing in putrefying flesh and visiting the surface to prey upon the living. According to legend, the only way to save yourself from him was to scream and yell like you were in unbearable agony. He'd assume you were already being tortured by one of his minions and leave you alone. How appropriate that his harbinger demon was a screech owl named Muon. I'll need to lift the statue somehow. This might represent one of the Lords of Shabalba. Those charged with crimes are brought here, and they battle under the watchful gaze of the gods, the only infallible judges. Those proven innocent may leave, but the guilty are killed and thrown to Shabalba. Amazing! Is this a pocket top court? Raise that ladder somehow. I'll need to find a way to raise the ladder to get the cart under it. Be a way to lift this ladder. Mm. I'll need to deal with the carts now. May 23rd. Over a month has passed since our expedition departed from Cuiaba. We have consumed our provisions methodically thus far, and continue to be in high spirits. Father's age shows when we're on foot. A few times now I have caught Rally looking over his shoulder and back at us to make sure we're still keeping up. Father always returns a look with a smile and saying he'll soon be the one in the lead. I'll need to deal with the carts now. Looks like this might be the way out. And in the moment the gods were satisfied Metnal did not kill his wife, a pelican landed at the accused's feet. This stunned those in attendance. This was a seabird, hardly ever seen this far inland. The representatives of the gods decided to see what the bird meant to do. It circled Metnal, flapping its wings and squawking softly, and then it opened its mouth and a half-eaten fish landed at Metnal's feet. This was understood by all as a sign of Metnal's guilt, and he was quickly executed. Need to tether the ladder again. Ladder isn't as rotten as it looks. Impossible. I can't carry anymore.
Thank you. Come see what I have to trade.
Everything is for sale. Except Remax drum. Enjoy it. Good deal. Thank you. Enjoy it. Come find me if you need anything else.
See what I have to tell you.
This describes something nearby. I lie silent where arrows once flew, guarding a door which will no longer open. Follow the Napo to the Amazon. Nothing but jungle for weeks. Phillips got the fever and I had to drag the bastard through this forsaken jungle for the last few days. He kept me awake every night, screaming something about being covered in snakes. Just when we were about to succumb to exhaustion, we arrived at a small settlement built at the foot of an ancient temple. The locals fed us and nursed Phillips until his fever broke. After asking around, I found out there's another temple close by, twin to the first. Once Phillips regains his strength, we'll explore these temples. This journey will not have been for naught after all. Should be helpful.
Oh.
The walls are porous. The oil must be seeping through. When the caverns begin to howl, a warrior must descend to ease the torment. If one cannot be sacrificed, then all will die. The elders of the village have lied to us. There is no beast underground. The howling we hear is only the wind rushing out through small caves leading to the surface. They've used fear to control us for too long. Once I make my way out of this infernal sweat bath, I will throw their lies at their feet. Is an ancient Maya god of war and death. So old, he is rumored to have been old even before the beginning of time itself. He is usually depicted as having no teeth and being colored entirely black. Little is known about him, except that he likes to smoke pungent cigars. Interestingly, he is also the god who invented drumming. Thank you. must be the way out. To get to that ledge. My way across. I'll have to time this right. Blockage on the other side. Need to find a way to destroy it. There's a blockage on the other side. I need more power. Thank you. strong for me to cross. There must be a way to unblock the shutters. Something's holding it in place. There must be a way to unblock the shutters. I'll need more power. There must be a way to unblock the shutters. There must be a way to unblock the shutters. There must be a way to unblock the shutters. There must be a way to unblock the shutters. A way to unblock the shutters. There must be a way to unblock the shutters. Now to get that other pendulum moving. Thank you. Time to get out of here.
Thank you. Are you interested in trading?
Thank you.
To find a way across.
Thank you.
Impossible. I can't carry any more. Full up. Can't carry any more.
Thank you.